So let me see here. So the basics. Well, the basics, of course, is all about getting to understand the Oracle licensing metric when it comes to technology. And over the years, Oracle has been going through quite a number of different metrics, and they've been changed as technology has evolved. So we've gone through power units, universal power units, named user, single server, named user, multi-server, and concurrent device licensing. And you'll probably see some of these licensing metrics. They're still out there. And you can still today migrate or upgrade to the most current licensing metrics that we have available today. But since 2001, the main two metrics has been name user plus, NUP in short, and then it's been the processor licensing metrics. And you will find almost any product, technology product out there being you're able to license using these two metrics. So they are by far the most common ones, and Oracle is doing utmost or their utmost to standardize this across all their engagement with all their customers. So they certainly want to see standardized licensing out there. And well, there's always a push to get someone to upgrade if they are on old licensing metric. But that's a whole other topic. In I just wanted to give you guys an understanding that there are still a lot of different licensing metrics out there. And you can, even today, from the oldest one, upgrade to the most current ones. Now, there is a conversion ratio or a migration ratio, if you will, between the processor, one processor license and one NUP or 50 NUP licenses. So it's a 50-to-1 ratio. And it's something you can always, it's a good metric to have in your back of your mind when you're looking at what metrics should I be using here? What's the ratio between the two? You can always, if you are in a situation where you have either NUP licenses or processor licenses, you have the opportunity to migrate between the two metrics. So if you are in a situation where you want to move to processor licensing, well, you can convert your existing NUP licenses to processor licenses and vice versa. So this is something that's it's very good to understand and know in certain situations, because you can quite often resolve quite big compliance issues if you have a old setup running, for example, NUPs or processors. So there can be a value for you to think about this conversion ratio. So when we look at the Oracle processor definition, so there is will be a processor definition in all your contracts or in your ordering document that will stipulate exactly how Oracle is thinking about what defines a processor. And in short, and this is the easiest thing to remember, Oracle defines a processor that needs to be licensed as all processor where Oracle programs are installed and or running. This is installed and or running. If you go and look in your actual contract, you will see a bit broader definition, but this is the main thing to remember. It's called installed and or running. And what it basically means is that, of course, if you are licensing a server with Oracle processor, it doesn't really matter if you're using that particular server or not. If Oracle is installed on it, you need to pay for a license. But what it also means is that if there is access, So if you put a server up in a cluster, or if you're running Oracle software in a cluster of servers, it ends up being the situation where you need to license each and every one of those servers within that particular cluster, because they have the potential to actually go in and run Oracle software. So, and this is one of these areas that becomes very important when you start talking about virtualization, because virtualization very often is, or in most cases, is a sharing of a large pool of hardware resources. So when do you use this metrics? Well, you use it in situations where you have, where you basically need unlimited access to the software. So, and the easiest way to basically define that is to look at the Name User Plus or the NUP licensing, where you have, which is basically the other option you have to license Oracle. So if you look at the NUP licenses, the Name User Plus is defined as an individual in, authorized by you to use the program, which are installed on a single server or multiple servers, regardless of whether the individual is actively using the programs at any time. Again, if you have it installed, you need to pay for a license, and you need to give them authorization to actually use it. So when do you use this type of licensing metric? Well, you use it in situation where you know who has access to the actual database. So let's say it's a database license, you will then count the number of users and devices that has access to this software. So that's the time where you use NUP licenses. So it's in controlled environments where you count and control the people or devices accessing the software, whereas processor licensing is in a situation where you don't have that control. So you would go for a unlimited license or access to your servers. So that's the definition, and it's best explained when you compare the two licensing metrics against each other. Again, if you are in a situation here, and this will also be in your contract, the Oracle will mention the term multiplexing. So if you're using your Oracle software in connection with an application or some device that is exposing or multiplexing the Oracle software to, for example, via the internet. So if you can access the Oracle software through the internet, that is considered a multiplexing situation. If you have such a situation, you need to count the users at the multiplexing front end. So that means that, let's say that you expose the Oracle software to the internet, you would need to count it at the end of at the internet. So who can access your software from the internet? Now, you might actually have put a restriction on it, like passwords and so on. But if you haven't, automatically you would need to go with a processor license, because no longer would it be unique people accessing. You wouldn't have control on the people who are accessing the software. They're not countable in a sense. So that's the difference between processor licensing and NUP licensing. So multiplexing, always count at the multiplexing front end. So we have the two licensing metrics. So we have NUPs and we have the processor licensing metrics. Those are the two main metrics that you will be using when licensing Oracle software. But you do remember that, or you have to keep in mind that it's not only the processor, it's also the named user plus licensing metrics. They are bound to the Oracle hardware that you are deploying your software on. So there is some licensing minimums that you have to keep in mind, for example, when you're licensing with NUPs. So when you calculate the need for a processor, it's not just counting the actual physical processes on your server. You need to basically go in and apply a core factor and calculate the number of Oracle processes that you need to license on a given server. So Oracle has a core factor licensing table, which they have published on the web, and you can go in and you can look into that core factor table and see what processor are you running, and for each and every processor there will be a core factor applied, and then you would need to go in, count the number of cores that are available to your Oracle software, and then apply a core factor to that to find the actual number of processors that they need to calculate. So in this case, we've gone in this example, you can see there's one server, there's two Intel cores here on 8-core processors. So you take, in this case, the one server, so number of servers, you multiply it with the number of processors. In this case, there are two processors, and then you multiply that with the number of cores and the core factor. So in this case, there will be 8 licenses, Oracle processor licenses, if you're running Enterprise Edition for this particular product. Now, if you were to do it on an NUP basis, you would go through the same calculation again. Instead, here you need to consider the actual number of people who are actually using, the actual number of devices that people and devices that has access to the software. But let's say that it's only a few people here, then you need to consider the Oracle hardware minimums, the minimum licensing requirements. You have to keep that in mind. So in this case, it's the same server setup, but we only have one active user. So to go in and calculate the minimums, you would go in again, take the same servers, the number of servers, you would multiply with the number of processes and cores and the core factor, and then you need to multiply the actual minimum use number for that particular product. In this case, we're talking about Oracle Enterprise Edition, and in this case, it's 25. So for the same server, the minimum uses applied to that particular server would be 200 new licenses. And then you have to weigh the real use versus the minimum license use if you're licensing with on an NUP basis. And of course, the highest number is what you need to license. Now, that is it's not always something license managers actually remember to do, but this is how you need to keep those minimum licensing rules in mind when you go in. Otherwise, it's going to be very, very cheap to license on an NUP basis. And Oracle's, of course, want to make sure that that's not entirely the case. But again, NUP licenses for controlled environments where you know who has access, processor licensing for those situations where you don't have control, where you basically need unlimited access. So the break even is, as we talked about, it's 50 NUPs to one processor. And with the minimum licensing, you can basically, if you compare a processor licensing to NUP, you can get away with half the licensing cost if you are able to follow the minimum licensing rules. So you don't have an actual number of user numbers that is higher than minimum licensing. So that is always something to keep in mind, and especially for controlled environments, if you're running in virtualized environments where you can't really do any subcapacity licensing, this is sometimes a good way to get out of a hotspot or difficult situation to consider the NUP licensing metric. So we have the first question here. So let me see. I'm just going to go in and share this with you guys. So just going to publish this one. So you're buying a database enterprise edition licenses for an application. New customer prospects can access from the internet. So your company, you have new customer prospects coming in for this application. And you have your Oracle database software running in the back end. So what are the recommendations in this case? Is it A, I must use processor licenses as there are unlimited access to the database? Or is it B, I can use both Noop and processor as the number of users are limited in the application layer? So I'm just seeing you guys coming in. Yeah. Limited in the application layer. Well, I can see most of you got it right. So let me see, what is the answer? The answer is, of course, A. You have to license process with processor as you don't control the population. So this limited the number through the application layer, that's just basically mumbo jumbo I'm making up. It's unlimited access. You cannot control the access from the internet. At least we've not set up the situation as if you have control and you don't understand the unique assets that are coming in. So this is the case here. Moving on. So question number 13, let me publish this one. So you have three DBAs accessing a test server. It's got 8 cores of 0.5 core factor running database enterprise edition. What are the recommended licensing metric for Oracle database enterprise edition? With Oracle, is it answer A? With Oracle, you only have to license production servers. Or is it B? I can use Noop and processor licensing, but Noop is less expensive in this case. Yeah, no, exactly. So you got that fully correct. In this case, Oracle, there's no, you know, you can run test for free type of environments, free for all giveaway with Oracle. You absolutely need to license all your environments. There is development type of licenses. If you're developing on Oracle, then there can be some situations where you don't have to license it right away. But Every other type of environments you absolutely need to license, and development is not then you're hard coding on Oracle technology. It's not counting anything else into that equation. So and in this case, yes, both processor and NUP can be used, but since you only have three and considering the minimum licensing need for on the NUP basis, well, then it's the most effective option. So in this case, we have everything. It's unique and countable, and there's no need for unlimited access.